found it. Sony thought it was a flagpole cleared up at the front of the park. Sammy noticed there was one flag too many.
How many should there be?
I was thinking six flags.
Sounds right. Let's get this question straight for the grand opening. Sammy, if you see King David or King Solomon, send them over here right now. I need to check out their costumes.
You got it, Anna.
Hey, where's the boss?
Right over there.
Who's in charge here?
She is. She's Hannah, the owner, the designer, the visionary, the brilliant behind Royal World.
It seems to me I'm late. The camels were supposed to be delivered hours ago. It's well past dark, and the grand opening of Royal World is in the morning. We're not even close to ready. At any minute now, some bureaucrat from Bethlehem's safety department is supposed to come inspect us.
Then you need that.
Yes. I know, right? I've spent half my life making this a reality. All I want to do is to create a theme park to make everyone proud of our little town. Put a smile on every day.
That's a good job.
You're telling me. I mean, look at this place. All I need is some know-it-all, self-important pencil pushers telling me that our theme park isn't safe. Anyway, drop those cameras off at the runway caravan right now.
And what makes you think I shouldn't bring camels?
Because you smell like a herd of camels. Either that or you're wearing dromedary number 9 perfume. Wait, you're not.
Who are you?
Name's Rizzo. I'm the know-it-all, self-important, pencil-pushing Bethlehem City safety inspector. Who apparently smells like a herd of wild camels. This is my assistant, Mia.
Hi.
Hey, you know, I was just saving. You've got enough problems without me adding to it.
Problems?
Yeah. A theme park in Bethlehem? Are you kidding me? You think you're going to make Bethlehem a tourist destination?
It's not just a theme park, it's Royal World.
Of course, King David was born here, but since he was crowned here as King of Israel, not much has happened in this sleepy little town. But we hope to change that. Look, it's been a long time since David was king. There's no king in Israel anymore. All we got are Roman centurions on every street corner. So, tell me about this Royal World.
Royal World is divided into three sections, past, present, and future. David Land celebrates our own native son, David, creator of Israel's past kings. Day Land celebrates Bethlehem today, and Prophecy Land celebrates the future, looking ahead to our forever king.
You right?
Yeah, that's our King David impersonator. Where have you been?
Getting into costume. This thing isn't easy to put on, you know.
Where's our King Solomon?
He was a little ways behind.
children's petting zoo?
What about it?
You need to lose the lion.
Lion? Whose idea was it to put a lion in the petting zoo?
Solomon's.
Thank you.
put a couple people in a pair of ox carts and shove them off the edge. Every time. That's why it's called a thrill ride. No, we got dozens of ox carts.
Want to know my favorite attraction? It's the one where you get to meet Goliath.
What's it called again?
It's a Tall World.
How could I forget? I can't get the tune out of my
head. Hey, where's Goliath now?
Solomon, don't you know what school is to tuck on Goliath's cape?
I bet he'd be already.
He's going to set up his kingdom and keep us safe the moment he gets here.
Can you imagine him as big as Goliath?
Oh. shepherds on the hillside. I raised them on my wits to stable. You won't believe what I have to say.
Let me tell you.
We're out past the edge of town, keeping watch over our flocks by night.
An angel of the Lord appeared to us, and the glory of the Lord shone around us. We were terrified.
But the angel told us, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that has great joy for all people.
Today is the time of David, a savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord."
Are you sure? Maybe you were dreaming.
No, this wasn't a dream. We witnessed it all.
Is that it?
No, right?
so long. We all have.
To put this little town of Bethlehem on the map.
You know what I'm beginning to think? I'm beginning to think that God has already taken care of that. What did the angels say to the shepherds? Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born. He is the Messiah, the Lord.
That's right, Hannah. And the people call it good news. And the people shall rejoice. It won't just put smiles on their faces for a few hours. God is fulfilling his promise of a Savior.
Well, come on, gang. Maybe we don't have a park opening, but how about we follow the shepherd's lead? We got some good, no, great news to share. Today, in the time of day, a Savior has been born.
If we could get everybody to stand and sing along with us for this last song.
God's amazing plan to save our souls from sin
started way back in the beginning and it's never stopped.
If you only knew the part about Jesus' birth in Bethlehem, then you'd probably hear it.